Hello, welcome to Executive Talk. My name is Maurice Washington. I want to welcome everybody to the show, those that are watching online and those that are watching the show later. In today's show, we're going to talk about the annual revenues. This is in continuation with a three-part series, and our first part of our series was called The Want. In today's series, it's called The Want versus the Desire. And then in our third series next week, we'll really dive into the annual revenues. So let's go ahead and kick in today's show and talk about, and let's first of all recap where we left off and just talk about the wants. In our first show, some of the highlighted features were there's a specific drive for money, drive that money creates for business owners. As a business owner, you know exactly what it does to you. When you know that you can reach a certain number by the end of the year, it kicks into your competitive spirit, which is great, and that's just part of being a business owner, and that's part of being a risk taker, and that's part of the annual revenue and what it does for you. Annual revenues also helps you understand your relationship with money. Do you like it? Do you try to get away from it? When you make the money, what do you do with it? Do you save it? Do you spend it? What do you do with money? It really helps you identify, because it's you alone that receives the money. So what is your relationship when it comes to money? We also highlighted that in your business plan. So if you were the one to actually write out a business plan, you know specifically that it shows up later. So in your business plan, you have the information regarding your business, and towards the end of your business plan, you see that it's towards the end. And that your first and foremost responsibility is to actually understand your business first, and then that will drive the annual revenues. We also get to actually determine how much attention it really requires. You know, it's very interesting to see how much attention, okay? It requires customer service. It requires for you to wake up early. Sometimes it requires you to wake up late. For you to maintain that business, what does it really require of you and of your time in order to make the annual revenue goal that you desire? We also have to understand that it's a very important aspect of your business. Money is very important. Without money, without revenue, there is no business. So it's a very important aspect, but also the trick of the matter is that you have to really understand the value of the annual revenue that you're trying to seek, that you're seeking, plus the customer service and the value that you're giving to your clients. And most importantly, actually, before we get there, it's one of the top five reasons why people start their businesses in the first place. Yeah, of course, this is my purpose. This is what I'm able to do. You know, I really love this. I really would like to do this. However, I want this amount of revenue going forward. And you know the opportunities within business can be extremely good based on some of the examples that you see out there in the marketplace currently. And most importantly, we discuss your wants and how does it affect your visual and your daily activity when it comes to your annual revenues. And that's what we discussed in last week's show. So in today's show, we're going to talk about the desire. Why is that different? So within the desire, truth be told, it's the same theme, but it's a different context, okay? So here's truth. Truth is, nobody walks around and says, hey, this is my desire. So when you're sitting down in a one-to-one and you're in the coffee shop and you're saying, hey, you don't say, yeah, my desire is to make $100,000 by the end of the year. No, you say, I want to make $100,000 by the end of the year. What do you want to do? That's the exchange and communication at that time. So what's the easiest way to distinguish the two? Why is that even something that you need to distinguish? And I think there's an undertone that we all need to actually pay attention to, and I'm going to go ahead and break that down for you. And you'll see this more in our first show when we talked about the want, but let's go ahead and break it down in this show and say the want specifically. So when I want something, and I'll go ahead and give you a business example, it causes irritation sometimes, doesn't it? Causes a level of impatience. It doesn't really require too much insight. When you want something, you just go and get it, and hopefully it works out. It doesn't need to listen. It needs to listen to specifically what it wants to listen to, and then it goes for his wants. That's the difference between a want versus a desire. It doesn't really perform duties with the right heart, does it? It doesn't seek balance. It's extremely short term. So when you're looking at your wants and your revenues, let's take a specific example. Let's take about when you're sitting down with a client and you go through your presentation, you answer questions the way that the client needs to. They understand, they nod their head, and that towards the end of that conversation, they say, well, you know, no, I really don't want to go forward, or I need to think about it, when we all know that's a gateway of really saying no. But when that answer happens, when you're coming from a want perspective, there's a certain opportunity that you miss. And from a want perspective, this is your first response. You know, you really inside you're saying, you really wasted my time. I can't believe we went through all this presentation. We did all this, and this is your conclusion. We spent all this time on the phone, and this is your conclusion. It causes that irritation. You get impatient with that person when they need to call you back. Okay? It doesn't perform the duties with the right heart. So when you want something, what are you wanting? I want to hurry up and finish this project so I can make my money, and then I can move on so I can continue making my annual revenue goal. And it is very short term. So at the end, so let's say you go along, you just burn through people and just meet with them until that person says yes, and that's all you're doing out there. And then by the end of the year, let's say you do make your number. It's very short term, isn't it? If you haven't planned for the following year, was that truly the right number? With a want, you never really quite know if that's a specific number or not, because all you were going for was a short-term goal. Now, yes, a year. So let's say January to December 2015, that was your year. Yes, that is particularly short-term. And as a business owner, you know that first year needs to impact the second year. So that's the difference in the want. Now let's talk about the desire. So it doesn't really irritate easily, does it? It's very patient. It actually does require insight. It does listen. It does perform duties with the right heart. It also seeks balance, and also is very much so long-term. So let's take that same scenario. I'm sitting down with the client, they say no. Now, if I see a string of that, now as a desire, my desire is to have a productive business so I can reach this annual goal all at the same time. I can sit here and say, this is a great opportunity for me to look at my business, look at the appointments that I had this week, and see how many no's that I've received. What was the consistent message? Was there something in my delivery? Was there something with a particular client I was meeting? Was it the wrong target market? But a desire allows me to not get irritated easily, but to truly require that insight that a business owner needs in order to see what it's doing, what's happening in a good way, and what's happening in a bad way. But that's what desires actually do for you. It puts it in a different undertone, in a different context. So how does the desire work for you in your business? The word desire puts everything into a perfect context. When you think about the truth of the matter, as a business owner, you know specifically that as a business owner, your business is, it can introduce anything into it. You can offer 24 items to your clients if you put your business in the right context. You have that opportunity. You can take on as many. So if you're business to business, okay, you can take on any business. You can set up your business so it doesn't matter what your business is. I'm just going to be able to work with them regardless, because somehow everybody needs me. Or if you're B2C, all these clients need me in some way, capacity, or form. But a desire says, I can work with these. This is my skill set, because as you know, as a business owner, you're purpose-driven. So your purpose is, this is my skill set, and I can affect those people in this category. It gives you a direct line. So now you have perfect context for your business. So let's be truthful about another thing. What are you really truly striving for? Okay, when you worked at your job, what were you striving for then? You were striving for security. That's really your first and foremost context when you're working for your annual revenue goal. Know your security number. What makes you feel secure? What is that number that you'll never question yourself, people will never question you under? What is your security point for you and your family? Now, I'm using everyday vernacular in the next exercise here, but there's three different levels of financial security. Just enough, more than enough, and well beyond enough. And let's break those three things down. So just enough means I'm doing okay. You know, I'm glad nothing catastrophic happened. Okay, we're not under the water, but you know what? I'm able to handle my family and pay bills and everything is taken care of, so I'm doing okay. So more than enough, what does that look like? Things are really looking up. That's when you hear those conversations of, man, this has been a really good year. It means that you hit your security, you hit your just enough level, but then more than enough says, I even made a little bit extra on top of that, which is what you're truly seeking. And that's probably what you're going for right now. Or you could be that category where you open your business and say, you know what? I want to go well beyond enough. That means I don't have to worry about anything else financially. Of course, that's where you want. Of course. Typically, the average business owner sets up their business model or the annual revenue model so they don't have to worry about money anymore. They skip over the first two because just enough, well, why am I opening up a business if I'm just going to make just enough or just kind of more than enough? They want to aim, typically a business owner wants to aim high immediately. There's nothing bad with it, but I want you to think about it. When you do well beyond enough things, it skips over the steps, and what you're actually driving specifically is the want. All you can do is want in that scenario, so really be careful about going well beyond. It's okay, it makes sense, but if you're not ready for well beyond, you could be setting yourself for failure and constant not reaching your number, which creates another reason or creates another opportunity for you to say, well, why am I even in business? Should I be doing this? You have to be really careful as far as your wants are concerned because they can have you missing a lot of steps. Whereas you desire, it would say, you know what, I desire to just make enough this first year, but just enough may allow you just enough training so you are ready for a bigger client. And because you've been consistent, now you're ready for well beyond enough. So let's move on. So what other true desires do you have for these numbers? Maybe you don't want to be questioned anymore. Maybe you're tired of people questioning you on, why are you doing that? Do you really know what you're doing? Should you be doing that? Maybe you're tired of that. Maybe your desire is to put a big check mark on this area of your life. I am so tired of being worried about money. It's just on my nerves. I'm done. I want to make this money today. Maybe that's your drive for your number. Maybe you're working to get somebody's judgment off your back. Have you ever heard the statement of, well, maybe you should be doing this so that way you can at least make some money, when that's not truly your heart desires and what you're really looking for? But there's a negotiation that ends up happening that you're not really truly acquainted with, and that's not really where you want to go? So think about this for a minute. My question is to you, are you running your business for the right reasons? If one of these three is how you started your business or why you're doing your business or your motivation for your business, I want you to stop right now. And for one, answer this truthfully. If this is you, and I want you to look at the first two statements, you don't want. You want. Your wants are, and again, with the undertone, you can't really decide if your wants or desires are in the way. If you're doing it based on desire, everything else will be taken care of. And you have to be able to trust in your desires versus your wants, because they can always, business ownership can always alter. So here are some five ways that desires can help you in your annual revenues. Now, I started with no limit, and I put a big question mark behind that. Primary focus. Client first, your activity equals financial security. The three numbers, and also the definition of success. So let's start with no limit. So I'm sorry for the multiple text, but I'm gonna go ahead and break it down for you. So have you read, have you heard No limit on your earning potential. Maybe you went to a seminar just recently or before in your career, and somebody said, hey, there's no limit to your earning potential. Or you've seen a post on Facebook or Twitter saying, don't worry, the only thing getting in the way of your earning potential is you, which is true. But let's think about that word, no limit. No limit immediately creates this mindset of unlimited income. That is exciting. How exciting is that to have unlimited income? You don't have to worry about money. Again, we talked about that big check mark. If that's what you're seeking, that's where that excitement comes from. And next thing you know, that's the only thing you think about. So let's think about the sacrifice of that. It sacrifices your relationship with your significant other, possibly. Maybe it sacrifices the relationship with your kids. Maybe it sacrifices your health. Here's what I mean by that. Potentially, there could be a limit. If you have to negotiate with your significant other saying, if your statement has ever been, hey, honey, if we do this for a whole year, and then by the end of the year, we'll have this amount of money, and then we can spend all the time we want together. However, right now, I probably won't see you that much. Okay? What if you have to negotiate with your kids? Hey, kids, I really want to spend more time with you. But I'm going to work this business really hard. I've been promised this amount of money. And then I can spend all the time I want with you. What if you negotiate with your health? You look in the mirror and say, myself, today we're not going to work out for the whole year. We're going to, starting today and going forward, we're not going to work out for the whole year. Or maybe we'll just do 30 minutes. But what I'll do for you, which is you're talking to yourself, which is weird. I know, I get it. However, we'll go ahead and get in the gym all day long because we'll have unlimited amount of resources to do this, and we'll just, that's just what we'll do. Are you making those negotiations? Have you had to make those negotiations right now? Are those the proper negotiations? Because the want actually creates those particular negotiations in your life. Whereas what do you truly desire? So what I'm getting at is, if you have all these in order, along with your annual revenue goals. So my desire is to have a healthy, productive business, to make $100,000 a year, and also have a good relationship with my family, kids, and also have a good, my health is in good shape. Then you have the whole picture. You have everything in the right particular order. But I'm going to submit to you today and challenge you on this. You could feel that I'm right. You could feel that I'm wrong. It's up to you. Only you know. But I'm going to submit to you this. If one or two of these things are out of sync, if your relationship with your significant other by the end of that year, because you negotiated this amount of time and you didn't meet your annual revenue goals, are you ready to have that conversation? Oh, well, honey, I didn't really quite make it. Are you okay with that? So there's a level of balance, again, that the desire puts you in to say, hey, I need to get off by 5 o'clock. And if I want this specific annual revenue goals, my numbers are going to be in line. So that way I can spend the right amount of time, make the right amount of sales, give the right amount of customer service, and still have all these other things intact. That's what you're looking for. You're looking for the whole picture. So what about primary focus? Desires gives you primary focus, because your primary focus is to have a productive, useful business, first and foremost. Something that people, that you're productive. You can constantly come back to every, hey, I got some work to do. Everything is good. Okay, working with this customer, got to follow up with this customer, got to do this. You have a productive business. Useful. People need your business. You set it up in such a way where people understand the need for your business and the value of it, so they're constantly coming back. Consistent number. And again, this relates to the annual revenue. It is so important to have that consistent number. That way you can depend on that number. These activities will yield me at the end of the year this amount of revenue. Now you know exactly what your business is. No longer is it a mystery, it's very specific. Now you start getting excited and you walk around proudly saying, yes, I am a business owner, and because you have the backing to prove it. And it's an attainable number. It's a number that you have no fear around. You progress years after years, and now it's no thing to make $100,000. It's not a thing to make 125 or 150 or even get up to 500K. That's what you're really looking for, so that's your desires. And your security at that point will never be threatened in these areas. And that's what we spoke about earlier. Really addressing the security that you really desire out of your annual revenues. So let's think about number three. Client first plus your activity equals your financial security, which places your business in perfect order. Why is it in perfect order? For one, it's client first. It is about the clients. It's about you understanding your skill set to work with your clients so they can get into a better position than what they were before they met you. That's really the primary purpose of you having your specific skill set. Plus your activity, okay? You will do the proper activity to work with the client first and to constantly feed that vehicle, which is your business, you don't have to question your financial security because you're constantly being in flow. That's all you're looking for. Now you have a purpose-driven business model because you're focused on the client first. Again, the desires place everything into perfect context. Define success. Do you want what comes with success? Really think about that. It's an easy word to say. It's an easy word to possibly even judge others, which, of course, you know, that's not what we're supposed to be doing. However, are you ready to deal with success? Okay, it comes with a certain responsibility, doesn't it? Does it scare you when you say, hey, I can make $120,000? Do you outwardly, it sounds like you're happy, but inwardly, are you shaking? Does it make you nervous? Really come to terms with that because you have to know that so you're not tricking yourself, because it's one thing to write down a number, but it's another thing to do everything not to achieve that number. That's where you can say, do you really want what comes with success, and are you ready for it? Okay, success does have its own vehicle. So let's think about this for a quick second. Okay, what happens to your favorite athlete when they do something not so intelligent? What happens to the company that does the wrong thing out there in the marketplace? Are you ready, if your company is that company, to be put on social media in such a way? There is a certain responsibility that comes with success. The more money you make, the more scrutiny you're under. So really understand there's a lifestyle behind success. So leading into that, every lifestyle comes with maintenance. So properly align your annual number based off of what you're willing to maintain. It's one thing to actually make $100,000 and have a $50,000 lifestyle. You can maintain it. You can easily get back to that number. And there's a way that, okay, if I change this, or even if you had to make a whole career change, you can get back to that number. However, let's say you do have a beautiful house. Let's say you do have the big car or multiple cars. Let's say you have the movie theater in the house. Just dream big. But does that come with a maintenance that you're willing to do on a regular, consistent basis? That's what it boils down to. Because I'm sure it's a lot harder or a lot easier to fall from 150 versus $1 million when you have three or four homes, and then you possibly have to liquidate that if something were to happen. It's very hard to recover, but are you willing to maintain it? If you are, then that's most certainly your number, but really come to terms with that. Success is based off of what you want, not what anybody else wants or needs to see. It's your number, something that you're able to maintain and that you're excited about, and that's what desire actually puts into proper context for you also. So let's think about the three numbers. Earlier, I said just enough, more than enough, well beyond enough. So, with just enough, let's say you net $50,000. Just enough, meaning you're able to net $50,000, which means that you're able to pay your bills. Life was good. Again, luckily nothing catastrophic happened, but you're able to maintain. That's just enough for you. So what does more than enough possibly look like? Well, you net it Okay, so just enough is 50. So this year you netted 75,000. That means you have $15,000 extra to play with. Now you're able to go on that extra vacation or have an extra amount in your savings account. That's what more than enough really looks like as for a business owner. And what about well beyond enough? Okay, so if just enough was 50,000, you're able to maintain that. Now, well beyond enough is you netted 100,000, which gives you an extra $50,000 of revenue to play with, to put in savings, to prepare for next year, and also go on an extra vacation and do what you want then you're in great shape. So I really want you guys here watching to really pay attention to your wants versus your desires when it comes to your annual revenues. Again, it's the same context, it's the same word, it has some of the same meanings, but there's a level of undertone that I want you guys to receive out of this particular message. And so with that being said, please join us next week. We're gonna talk about the annual revenues, and we're actually gonna do a whole breakdown of what the annual revenues really look like and to really understand that number. But in the meantime, if you can go to Facebook and like us over there at Executive Talk and keep up to date with our posts, find our meetup group on Executive Business Talk Show, Instagram under Executive Talk, and follow us on Twitter under Exec Talk. We'll see you there. But right now, I got to get back to work. Have a great day.